Meanwhile, the Labor Department gives its assurance assistance will be extended to undocumented Filipinos who are forced to come home due to Saudi Arabia's crackdown on illegal residents. Pia Gutierrez also tells us the Philippines and Saudi Arabia have signed a bilateral agreement to give better protection to Filipino workers.
When Saudi Arabia started its crackdown against undocumented foreign workers, runaway OFW Lorenzo Lumbes spent 2 months at the deportation center in Jeddah. Despite the trauma suffered during his stint in Saudi, Lorenzo's first priority when he eventually returned home was to renew his passport for another job abroad.
Siyempre, marami pa rin problema. Tulad ng walang inuwi, walang pera.
Migrante says the problems of runaway OFWs from Saudi do not end with their repatriation back to the Philippines.
Ang unang nilang tanong, paano sila mag-start ng buhay nila rito?
In the next few months, thousands more distressed OFWs are expected to fly back home due to Saudization. The Labor and Employment Department assures the public measures are in place to assist the OFWs. They may be redeployed abroad, get jobs here in the country, or put up their own businesses.
They can immediately avail of the balik pinay, balikhanap buhay na livelihood na pwede na nilang simulan.
Government has set aside 2 billion pesos for a special loan program exclusively for OFWs who want to set up their own business. To avail of a loan, one must undergo training with the National Reintegration Center for OFWs and submit a business plan. An OFW can get as much as 300,000 to 2 million pesos, payable in not more than 7 years. As for those still working in Saudi, they can now enjoy better protection after the Philippines and the Kingdom sign a bilateral agreement. The deal covers recruitment, deployment, and assistance for runaway workers. Both sides also streamline the process of hiring household service workers. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.